Hi, my name is Matthew Rocknich. I am the developer evangelist here at DocuSign. I'm here today with Kiran Kaza. He is the Senior Director of Mobile Engineering. Kiran, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me, Matt. It's a pleasure.
So Kiran, correct me if I'm wrong, but you are responsible for leading all efforts relating to mobile. Is that correct?
Yes, I am responsible for leading mobile engineering platform. So anything mobile is typically my team doing the work.
Excellent. So can you talk a bit about the scope of mobile at DocuSign? How are we committed to mobile?
So the team today is focused on primarily doing development on our award-winning mobile apps for iOS, Android, and Windows, as well as my team today is also doing development on SDKs. So awesome. Mobile SDKs is another focus my team has.
Very cool. Let's talk specifically about the iOS native SDK.
Absolutely. The core principle we thought about while we were building our iOS SDK was, A, it should be easy to use. Mm. The developers should be able to download our SDKs and customize the SDK so that it looks and feels like their app because they are actually embedding my SDK within their app. And finally, we should provide the same nice UI experience that our native apps have within the developer's native application. So Right. They have their own application, but they want to use DocuSign signing experience within their apps.
Right. As a business leader, as a developer, I'm interested in the key value propositions. Could you walk through some of those for us?
Yes, absolutely. The first value proposition that we talk about in our SDK is, are we trying to solve a repeatable business problem? The answer is yes. Mm-hmm. And that's in DocuSign world are called templates. We use templates to solve the problem of repeatable business workflows. The second aspect is my SDK easy to implement within your app? Because that is one of the core principles behind our SDK design. So we have tons of documentation, sample apps to help developers come to speed as well as use our SDKs.
Right.
Finally, you might be collecting information or you might be conducting some kind of business process in a remote location where you do not have internet connection. So maybe in a Somalia desert. If that happens, our SDK should be able to still work. And yes, it does. Our SDK works in offline mode. So that is another important value proposition for our SDK.
That's so cool. What specific features does our SDK really, how do we demonstrate those features?
As I mentioned before, our SDK's first and big feature is being able to view templates and able to download them for offline usage. Mm-hmm. And the second key feature is being able to send those templates out for signing, being able to collect those signatures. And finally, you want to sync the envelopes back to the server. So those are kind of the top three, four functionality. On top of it, as I mentioned, we allow you to rebrand our SDK native user interfaces, as well as we allow you to default information during signing sessions so that when user has information that's already existing within their app, they're not repeating that again. That whole information can be carried forward in the signing session, and the signing process is basically you're collecting signature, maybe some information that you could not default or
Sure. Pre-fill. Awesome. So as developers, we love to know how things work. Let's take a look under the hood and figure out how the SDK is actually built.
Yeah. At a very high level, SDK, as I mentioned before, is a dynamic Objective-C framework. Mm-hmm. The second is it supports platform, which is iOS, right. 10+, any 10+ device, iPad or iPhone, it works. And documentation, we provide tons of documentation, startup guide, bootstrap documentation, we provide information on interfaces, some sample apps. So that at the high level. Let's go a level deeper, which probably will excite most of the developers. One, if you look at this drawing with me, it looks like a very familiar MVC drawing, which is absolutely what our SDK is. It is following MVC architecture. At the very bottom, you have data that interacts with controllers. Controllers interact with views. But from developer point of view, all you interact with is the client interfaces that we have created, which you use within your application. So all the complexity is gone.
You mentioned that we're going to walk through some code. Are you going to give us an example of the SDK in action?
Absolutely, I will.
Great.
If you think about our SDK, there are really four key steps to use our SDK. One, being able to authenticate using our SDK with DocuSign. Mm-hmm. Number two, being able to access templates and be able to download them for offline usage. Three would be your own business process of collecting, sending documents for signature, and then finally syncing them. So mm-hmm. really, there are four key steps that our SDK, you use our SDK within your app.
Okay.
Let's understand the first step, authentication. You have your own application, you have your own authentication model, but you need to authenticate yourself with DocuSign. So on the left-hand side, you see a little code snippet, and this code snippet indicates we need four different data points. One, what is your DocuSign user ID, password? Mm-hmm. You're going to pass in an integrator key. The integrator key basically helps you identify who you are with DocuSign, and finally the host. Host is like different environments you're going to use for your testing,
right.
Lower environments doing non-production phase and production environment for production. So those would be the four different values you pass, a single line of code, and you can authenticate yourself with DocuSign. Let's look at that in real life. What you're looking at is insurance company app. The code base, entire code base, is actually for your business problem that you are dealing with.
Right.
But at different places, you will add information so that you can use DocuSign SDK. So let's look at a login view controller. A view controller is basically a way to communicate between views and models, right? So here I'm passing in literally three lines of code, and which is a username, password, host key, and integrator key, and you're integrated. So let's look at that flow here. Now I'm able to log into the application, or you see the user ID and password being defaulted. I hit sign in. I'm authenticating myself into my own application, and I'm logged in.
Excellent.
So step two here is I need to view templates and be able to download for offline usage. So the top part of the code shows you how to view a template. A second part of code shows you how to download them for offline usage. Let's go back to my application. And you can see in my template manager, mm-hmm. I have, obviously the name is obvious, the template manager.
Yeah.
Well, there are two pieces of code. First, this is the first call you make to DocuSign system to retrieve a list of templates. So there's a list template call. And then you call another call where you pass in a specific template ID and ask it to be cached for offline usage. I'm gonna go back to my app here. I'll go to templates. There's one template which is already cached. You can see a little check mark here, but this template is still not cached. The home insurance template is not cached. I'm gonna click on that. So now it's actually downloaded the template for offline usage.
So now if you're in the field and you don't have access to any, you know, cell reception or Wi-Fi, you all automatically have those templates ready to use.
Exactly. Excellent. And you never lose your work. It's always there.
Cool.
So then step after that is sending and signing. So I have now the template that I wanted to use. I'm actually collecting a claim information.
Sure.
I'm in the field. Now I have to send and sign and send documents. So this with one line of code where you pass in a template ID. I'm going to pass a template ID, a kind of business process what I'm dealing with right now. I'm going to pass in the default data, which are DAPs.
Sure.
And finally, any kind of attachments you might have to pass in. For example, there are many scenarios where if you are at a site, you have to take a driver's license, a copy of a driver's license, some kind of information.
Proof of insurance, ID.
Something to validate who the person is. So we can attach that information, and that's it. That one line of code will let you start from starting a claim information, collecting the data, and finally signing and finishing off the document. That entire flow is through one line of code.
That's amazing.
And let's go back to our app here. Here, at the very end, I have the call to call the template manager, and the template manager call will actually kick off the entire sending and signing experience. So let's look at that in a real app. So this again, my claims app. I'm actually trying to create auto claim.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna click on auto claim. I'm gonna select the template. So I'm gonna search for a valid policy. And this is for Tom. So I'm creating a claim for Tom.
Right.
I'm in the field. I hit next. I know I'm creating a claim for auto accident. And when you hit next is the point where you actually make a call to our SDK, and I'm signing in the offline mode. I'm gonna attach some kind of driver's license, something, proof of insurance, something.
Sure.
And now, at this point, I'm adding who is signing this document with me. So I'm in the field with you. So I'm gonna say I'm host signing here. I'm a host, I'll add myself. And the person who's signing is Tom Woods.
And I'll be Tom Woods.
you'll be Tom Woods for this example. And you host the signature. You're signing offline mode. And
so at this point, me as Tom Woods, I'm accepting the phone, and I'm gonna start the signing ceremony.
Exactly.
Okay.
So I hand over the device to you. You read the consent. You say, I'm begin signing. I'm gonna fill in, hey, where did that accident happen? So the first form, I'll fill in, hey, 211 Main Street.
Perfect.
So basically, only information I'm writing is what I don't know, where the accident happened.
Sure.
Everything else is defaulted. The name is defaulted. The policy number is defaulted, as you can see there. The SDK projects are full defaulting. Now, all I have to do is sign. So let's sign this document.
Beautiful signature.
Oh, I am so good with my keypad.
Oh my God. Perfect.
So I collected my signature, and all I had to do is hit finish button. So I hit finish, confirm signing. I pass the device back to the host. And this entire workflow is through one line of code that you added that kicks off that entire flow. So that's how easy it is to use my SDK.
That's right.
And I have signed the document. I wanted to show another flavor where it is quite possible that you want branding. Right now, in my insurance app, you're seeing most of the flows are bluish. Yeah. But if for some reason you want it orange, you set your navigation tab bars to specific colors and font to specific colors, it will show those document specific colors.
Right. I wouldn't have noticed that we transitioned from third party to DocuSign if you hadn't mentioned branding.
Yes. Awesome. So that way, the whole experience looks cohesive. Mm-hmm. And finally, syncing. I collected signatures. I want to sync the document back to the server. You had to add this one line of code, and they'll sync the document back to server. Let's look at this in real life. So I have envelope manager. So we are syncing envelope back to server. And all you're doing is say, hey, sync this envelope back.
Excellent.
So I go back to my SDK, sync claims. And now you see the sync happening back to the servers. Done.
That's very clean.
Yeah, so. Simple. So simple, probably 20 lines of code, and you're done.
Perfect. I'm sold. As a developer, if I were to get started, where would I go personally?
So for developer point of view, the first place you should go is developer.docusign.com. Once you are there, you can navigate to our SDK, SDKs and tools. Mm-hmm. In SDKs and tools, there is an iOS offline SDK section. And here, once you come to the section, you will have Developer Center. On Developer Center, there are all the information about how you're going to bootstrap the app, how you're going to how can you use this how can you use other documentation, the sample apps, so on and so forth. Everything is available. You can even download our SDKs from the same site.
Amazing. Anything new upcoming for developers to get excited about from the SDK's perspective?
Oh, great question. From developer point of view, we got feedback and we have made some enhancement. We added additional tab support. For example, we support radio buttons, date formula fields. We have added some advanced recipient controls, for example, being able to switch recipient type. Mm-hmm. Right now, most of the SDK flows are template-driven flows. Mm-hmm. You need to have a template to kick off the workflow. But in future, we want our SDKs to be driven by any document, can collect signatures on any document which are on the local device or some kind of cloud storage. So that's the next version of our SDK where you can start your document signing just based on a document versus a template. So that's a second version which we are releasing end of next month.
Excellent. Very, very exciting stuff. Now, for all the developers out there, if you are interested in any mobile development opportunities, jobs, are there any currently at DocuSign? Can they apply?
We are growing. Our team is rapidly growing. There are tons of positions on DocuSign career side, mm-hmm. both for San Francisco, Seattle, and other development locations we have. Please apply. We love to have fresh energy join our team.
Excellent. Well, Kiran, thank you so much for being here today to talk about the iOS SDK.
It was fun. It was great.
Thanks so much.